Hello everybody and welcome to episode 3 of FTB Beyond with me, Super Troops. Who else did you expect? Anyway, so I've been mining in between episodes and just finished. Put some bits on the crappy shack just to make it bearable. Let's see, very simple. But yeah, there's a few things I wanted to get done today which I didn't want to do off camera, so I'm going to do it on camera. So I've also started going mining. My mining trip was okay. I got a bunch of redstone, one diamond, one. That's tiny coal. Yeah, got a bunch more iron, which was something I definitely needed. And I also went off and got a load of clay, sand, gravel, so we can make the gravel, so we can start to get a tinker smeltery going. So I'm going to cook that grout up and let that go. I might need another furnace in the meantime. Oh yeah, I forgot I set them off. I will get this eventually. Bam. Okay. Looks like I still got a tiny coal in there. Alright. So, I was looking like the cobblestone started to get out of control, so let's look at Yabba first. Okay, so we need a chest and a barrel upgrade, so that basically means we need some iron bars. That is doable. I'm trying to not use as much ore as possible whilst I haven't got some way of doubling it, because that's just wasteful. Hence the smeltery is a start. Okay, so that's iron bars, so we need some wood. We're not gonna have enough wood, so let's go chop a tree quickly. I still haven't added fast leaf decay yet, but it's on the cards. This is ridiculous waiting for leaves to drop. Okay, so I'll get some planks. Awesome. And I want a chest. I noticed when I was mining, my computer was running along at 348 FPS. So I've just limited it to 180 and 90 odd FPS is fine whilst I'm up here. Whilst there's in a chunk with entities ticking, which is what kills FPS. Right, so what was I doing again? Oh, I need another chest. Who knew? Okay, so it's, and then the iron bars, so I'm going to need to take all this off, because complete waste of time. I need to do this, iron bars. Oh, that's 16 upgrades, didn't know you got that many from it. Oh well, it's useful. Okay, so I may as well make a chest quickly because I can need a chest for useful stuffs. Put that in there. So we've got a barrel, and these were the same as the other barrels, so we need to have it back in the 1.7 days. So I can take all of that. Yeah, double click it and it all goes into there. There's nice that it's got an actual interface and it says what's in there underneath writing now. It's quite nice. They can hold 64 stacks and you can upgrade it as well. Yeah.
Got a little Swedish there.
Yeah.
That's good. So that clears all that stuff out of the way. Awesome. Is that done? So one thing I want to do, my wheat is going strong now, so I can start thinking about this. So I need furnace generator. Which involves, I can do this. So I need 4, 9, 9 iron.
Yeah.
A bunch of redstone. Just waiting for that. So, as you can see, berries galore. Which is good. Tons of blueberries. I'm just going to juice them all up quickly. So, we've got noms. Nice. 20 bottles of juice now. That's the wrong chest, but who cares? Okay, so I'm saving up my wheat because.
Damn!
Well, I'll show you when I get to it. I don't really need to be eating bread at the moment anyway. Rice is going strong. So I can plant them last two seeds. Oh, yeah, flax. String. All the string.
Yeah.
Them strawberries take ages. Right, yeah, the only reason I'm doing strawberries is because strawberry juice.
Yeah.
Okay, rice is good because we can make rice slime balls out of that. Saves us having to go hunting for slime islands and stuff. Slime chunks. So that's good. Industrial hemp's going along nicely now. At some point, this will go onto a forestry farm because I want to do all the industrial engineering stuff just because I haven't bothered to ever go as far as the diesel generator before. It'd be nice to just do it and automate it. Alright, so first thing I need is that. I'm getting more weather. Time. Yeah, let's do this first. Okay. Axe is about to break, of course. And punch it wood. Alright. One thing I did want to grow out here as well. I've got 3 apples now, so I can do that. And have an apple tree. Start here. So I can make apple juice too. Nice. Alright. So I needed wood. So let's get back a good look. So a chest. Redstone, 4 iron, and that gives us 4 machine blocks, which is useful. Furnace generator is none I'm gonna need. 8 cobble, thank you very much, pal. That goes there, that goes there. There you go around that. That's our furnace generator. I could just burn stuff in there and make electricity that way, but I'm gonna have to go kill an animal. It's something I haven't really done yet. Just been living off berries and fruit. Oh no, I did have some mutton right at the start. Forgot about that. Thank you very much, Kyle. Thank you for the achievement. So I just gotta go cook that steak. And that is that mess of a chest full. I'm gonna have to separate off flowers and plants shortly. Right, where's that useful stuff? So I can go in there. So I need 5 wheat, 2 redstone, and the cooked steak. So, not there. 2 redstone. Steak is there. Cool. So we have a culinary generator. And what this does, what I'm going to do is just do an example. So. Can't put wheat in there because it's not actually edible, I don't think, anyway. No. So, I'm going to waste one of these just because. Okay. So you can see that gives you 30 seconds of burn time in the calorie generator for just bread. As if you just cook it up. Into toast, and once this is done, so 30 seconds gives you 24,000 RF. Whereas if you put the toast in, you get 58 seconds. Put that wheat away. Away. It's still cracking on. It's already gone over. So that's what, 65,000 RF. So for the sake of just cooking your bread into toast, you get almost 3 times the amount. And the good thing is, it doesn't continue burning, it just stops at the point where it's at when it's full, like it is now. Which is nice. Especially when you have a wheat farm right outside your front door. Oh good, our seared bricks are done. Alright, so we could definitely make a stack of these, at least in 2 blocks. Right. I think I'm just going to put it over here, so I'm just going to quickly punch these because I haven't got a shovel that is busted at the moment. I can always break this down and move it later. I kind of feel like I want a 3x3. I normally go for 2x2. Now that that's possible with Tinker's Construct, but I miss the old 3x3 smelteries. Two stacks is enough for a 2x2 generator. So I'm thinking one more stack should do it. Split it up. So 3 more toast for you. Alright, then we started to make progress. So, yeah, immersive engineering. So I want some sort of passive power collection as well, which just gives me some permanent power. So, first step to that is the coke. Is that railcraft there? Good. 27 blocks, which means I need 14, so it's 14 to 28. 56 bricks. And 56 clay. Start our coke oven. Now, which route do I want to go down? NDIO is the obvious route with the sag mill and the alloy furnace. And I will have to do that at some point anyway, but as it's new into 1.10, I think I'm going to go this way. Tin. 5 iron and some quite clear glass. Copper gears. Might wait till I have the smeltery, you know. I think that's a wise idea. Anywho. Already. Okay. About that. spooky. That's good. So I just need the funnels and then the controller and the tank. Which means I need 25 more bricks. Alright, that's good. Oh, are they grown? Thank God for that. Right. Some lemon seeds, so we can accelerate this a bit. Hemp for days. But I'm more interested in the seeds, to be honest, because I don't think hemp's much use. So a hemp fiber bowstring. Hemp rope coil as decoration. Gunpowder barrel. Whatever. Hempcrete. No idea. And you can make string out of it as well. Kind of negates the flax a bit. Cool. Put this stuff away. Dirt. That should be enough. We've got a few extras to start building it up. But once we've got it built, we could just put stone into the smeltery itself and it will make seared stone. So, who actually cares? Alright, so 1, 2, 3. Controller. And then a glass in the middle. That makes my tank. Cool. So, 1, 2, 3. And I like the fact these have outputs on the other sides as well, and what that means is we can add more basins and stuff if we really want to, which is also pretty cool. Alright, so controller. And there we go. And the reason I like a 3x3 straight away is because we get space for 18 ores right off the bat, which is nice. So you could do 36 ingots at a time. Alright, so, yeah, you can live in there now. I'll come back to you and make that taller. I don't think there's any way to do more than all double in this without getting ridiculously complicated, so I may even just automate this. But one thing I do want to check out is how to make a tank. Thermal expansion had tanks. Yeah, and you just upgrade it with the new upgrade system. Oh, God. Redstone servo. Oh, sorry. Iron, copper. I need 1 iron, 1 copper, and 3 quite clear glass. It's a slightly different recipe to what it always used to be. Have I really not got any copper? Wow, okay. Well, I did see some over here, up there. I've got a shovel, I need to replace my tools. Screw it. Wonder if I'll get people shouting at me for using a pickaxe on dirt. There we go. Right, well, there's a few bits of copper. I guess I need to do mining at a higher level. Oh, I can hear a basalt or something. Gross. Yeah, I forgot thermal expansion adds them mobs back into the game. Right, so I need one copper and one iron. And then three sand. Bonus seed brick. Okay, copper. That's gonna make the glass, that's gonna make that. That's quick. Let's make this first. So we need four redstone. Go in the corners. That is a redstone servo, apparently. New one on me. I bet we don't even need quite clear glass. I bet it's rotating, so. Cool. That holds 10 buckets now. That's nearly done. Okay, yeah, I've got my bucket. So, fortunately, in this mine that we started, quite quickly came across lava. I'm just gonna head down there quick. Yes, and there is this big lava pool here, but there's many, many more further along where I've been mining. There's many. We're not going to be short on lava for full. Wow, that thing's tough. Meow. Love FTB utilities. Okay, so for now you can just sit there, but I will eventually have this piping in. Okay, so got aluminium brass ingots. It's copper and zinc. How do I make a zinc? Have I even come across zinc yet? I don't even know if I've come across zinc yet, to be honest. No. I've only got the one aluminum ore. Okay, so zinc's in the game, but it's not in the game. There's no ore. sense. Think dust. I'm pretty sure ferrous is nickel, so that's not. Oh, where are the monsters? Where? They're like literally all underground. Let's see if I can stick this over here for a minute. Let's move it around a bit. Cool. That's nickel. I just want to see what this does in here. I'm sure this isn't how it works. Aluminum ore, really, it's only between 47 and 60. So 60 through to 47. Fair enough. Oh, it's just molten nickel. So you can't get zinc, so you have to get aluminium, basically, is what it's telling me. Which is reasonably annoying. Let's try a 51. See how rare this stuff is. There's copper, which is good. Okay, well, in the spirit of not having you watching mine, I'm gonna wrap up there and leave it until after I've done a bit of mining. I'm not sure what's going to be the next episode yet. It's probably going to be along the lines of getting ready for the thermal expansion. Look at my face. The thermal expansion machines, or maybe just giving up and going for Ender Iron. We'll see which one comes first. So until next time, bye!